B'siyata d'shmaya, we're going to learn Sukkah Daf Mem Aleph. We're going to start from the next Mishnah, approximately in the middle of the Omud, Mem Aleph, Omud Aleph. Says the Mishnah, Borishoino, at first, in the time of the Beis HaMikdosh, Hoya Luluv Nitel B'Mikdosh Shiva. Then the Pasuk says, Usmachtem Lifnei Hashem Elokeichem Shivas Yomim, that the Chiyuv Min HaTorah to shake Luluv in the Beis HaMikdosh was 7 days. Uban Medina, and outside the Beis HaMikdosh, including Yerushalayim, Yom Echad, the Chiyuv Min HaTorah to shake Luluv is just 1 day. Mishachorav Beis HaMikdosh, that after the Beis HaMikdosh was destroyed, Hiskin Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated, Sheyehi Luluv Nitel B'Medina Shiva, that whereas in the time of the Beis HaMikdosh, the 7 days Luluv was only in the Beis HaMikdosh, and everywhere else they only shook Luluv 1 day. Now that they don't no longer have a Beis HaMikdosh, in order to remember the Beis HaMikdosh, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai said, everybody should take Luluv 7 days as a Zecher LeMikdosh. And another Gzeira, another takon of Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, v'shihe yoim hanaf kulei osur. What's yoim hanaf? The day of waving. What's that? This is the 16th of Nisan, the second day of Pesach, where they would bring the Korban Oimer, which included waving the Mincha, waving the Korban Oimer. And until the point of the second day of Pesach, when the Korban Oimer was offered and brought, till that point, any new produce was not allowed to be eaten. From the 16th of Nisan, after the Korban Oimer was brought, then one was allowed to eat Chodosh, which is the new produce, the new grains of that year. But that was all when they had the Beis HaMikdosh. When they had the Beis HaMikdosh, until the Korban Oimer was brought, it was Osir, and afterwards it was Mutter. Once they no longer had the Beis HaMikdosh, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated that one should not eat Chodosh for the entire day of the 16th of Nisan, and one should only start eating Chodosh the next day, the 17th of Nisan. And this is learnt out from Psukim in Menachas Tav Samaches. Says the Gemara, we mentioned in the Mishnah that Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai said that in order to remember the 7 day chiyuv min haTorah of taking lulav in the Beis HaMikdosh after we lost the Beis HaMikdosh was that everywhere else, whereas in the time of the Beis HaMikdosh they would only take lulav 1 day, on the first day they would now start shaking lulav 7 days. How do we know? Who told Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai that there's such a concept of making a remembering a Zecher LeMikdosh? Om Rabbi Yochanan says that it's alluded to in a Pasuk in Yirmiyah, the Omar Kro, it says in the Pasuk, Ki Aale Aruka Loch, that Hashem says that I will give you an Aruka, a cure, Umi Makisayich Erpoich, and from your wounds I will heal you. No'um Hashem, says Hashem, Ki Nidocha Koru Loch, because you were called discarded, rejected, Tzion he, it is Tzion, it's the name of Yerushalayim, Dairash Ein Lo, and there's nobody who's seeking Yerushalayim. That's what it says in the Pasuk of Yirmiyah. The Gemara says, Dairash Ein Lo, from the fact that the Pasuk is so to speak complaining that nobody is seeking and inquiring and wanting to follow Yerushalayim, Michlal Deboy Adrisha, from there we can deduce that one should seek Yerushalayim even during the time of Churban, and that taught Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai that after the Churban Beis HaMikdosh, one should instate a Zecher LeMikdosh for the 7 days of Lulav, and therefore we all take the Lulav for 7 days, Midrabbonon, only the first day is Min HaTorah. Continues the Gemara, V'shihei Yoim Hanaf. We saw at the end of the Mishnah that Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai said that in the time of the Beis HaMikdosh, till the Korban Oimer was brought, on the 16th of Nisan, you're not allowed to eat the Chodosh, the new produce, the new flour. After the Korban was brought, then you could eat the Chodosh. After the Beis HaMikdosh was destroyed, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated that one should not eat Chodosh for the entire 16th of Nisan. My tam, what would be the source of that? What was Rabbi Yochanan afraid of? Answers the Gemara, Mehera Yibona Beis HaMikdosh. Because we're afraid that maybe this Beis HaMikdosh will suddenly get rebuilt. V'yoimran, people will say, Ishtakid, mi lo yachalnu beheir mezach. And before we continue, I just want to introduce what's really going on here. Min haTorah, there's one pasuk that says that the new produce is allowed to be eaten from the morning. There's another pasuk that says that new produce can be eaten from when the Korban Oim has been brought. So min ha-Torah, the way we reconcile these two psukim is that in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, when the Korban Oim is brought, then you are not allowed to eat the Chodosh until the Korban Oim is brought, and after the Korban Oim is brought, you can. When there's no Beis HaMikdash and no Korban Oim, then as soon as the 16th of Nisan sets in the morning, one's allowed to eat Chodosh. That's min ha-Torah. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated and said no. He said that the whole 16th you should not eat from the Chodosh. The question is why? So the Gemara says, because maybe the Beis HaMikdash will suddenly be rebuilt. V'yomran, people will say, Ishtakeid last year, Miloya Chalnu Beher Mizrach, did we not eat the new produce, the new grains from the morning? Hashtanami Nechal. So this year we can also eat the new Chodosh straight away in the morning of the 16th. V'inu lo yodi, and they won't know, the Ishtakeid, that last year, Deloy have a Beis HaMikdash, because there was no Beis HaMikdash, Heir Mizrach Hitir, as soon as it became light, it was the morning, that's when one's allowed to eat from the new Tavua. Hashta De'ikah Beis HaMikdash, but now that we have a Beis HaMikdash, Oimer Matir, you're only allowed to eat the new produce after the Korban Oimer, and people won't realize that. And therefore, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated, even during the Golus, don't eat the whole day. And that way, even when the Beis HaMikdash is built, in that first year, people will not eat Chodosh too early before the Korban Omer was brought. Says the Gemara, I don't understand. And to summarize, before we see inside what the Gemara is about to ask, the Gemara is about to say that we can always take it for granted that in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, by midday, the Korban Omer was definitely brought. And therefore, the people who lived further away from the Beis HaMikdash, who didn't know exactly what time the Korban Omer was brought, those people that knew, for example, if at 8 o'clock in the morning the Korban Omer was brought, they knew 8 o'clock you can eat Chodosh. The people that didn't know, people that lived further out, when were they allowed to eat the Korban? When were they allowed to eat Chodosh? So the Gemara is going to say, from midday, because midday is by that time definitely the Korban Omer has been brought. The Gemara is now going to ask, if you're afraid what's going to be next year when the Beis HaMikdash is going to be brought and built, people might get confused with the previous year, then it's good enough for Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai to say, don't eat Chodosh until midday. The next year there'll be a Beis HaMikdash. What's the worst that will happen? Worst that will happen is that they'll eat from midday. Midday is always okay to eat Chodosh. The Gemara is going to answer, we're afraid for a situation where that first year, Mehira Yibon HaMikdash, so the Beis HaMikdash is going to be built in the last minute before the 16th of Nisan, and they won't have time to prepare the Korban Omer, and all the whole process of preparing that mincha, the cutting it, the sifting it, the grinding it, the putting it through the many sieves, etc. And therefore, maybe that particular year, they will actually, in the Beis HaMikdash, bring the Korban Omer after Chatzos. In which case, that min ha-Torah, you're only allowed to eat Chodosh later on in the day. And the people might not know that. And in order to be safe, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated that the whole day one should not eat Chodosh, and if the Beis HaMikdash gets built, that whole day they won't eat it, and by the end of the day, the Korban Omer will definitely have been brought. Let's see this inside. Says the Gemara, De'iboni Amos, at what point you're afraid that suddenly the Beis HaMikdash will be built, and people will think that this year with the Beis HaMikdash is the same as last year, when in truth it's not true. Last year there was no Beis HaMikdash, so straight away Heir Mizrach, as soon as it's light, you can eat the Chodosh. With the Beis HaMikdash, you need to wait for the Korban Omer. The question is, when was the Beis HaMikdash built? Ilemed Ivni B'Shitzar, is it talking about that the Beis HaMikdash got built or finished getting built that day, sometime that day of the 16th of Nisan? Harehitir Heir Mizrach. Since at the first moment in the morning of the 16th, the Beis HaMikdash was not yet completed, then the pasuk that says you can eat Chodosh right away in the morning applies. So there's no issue, let them eat Chodosh. Elod Iboni B'Chameisa, are you talking about the Beis HaMikdash was going to finish being built on the 15th of Nisan? Michatzois Hayoimul Halon Tishtari. It should be mutter to eat the Chodosh from the midday of the 16th of Nisan. Dot none, did we not learn in a Mishnah in Maseches Menachos, Harachaikim, the people that lived a little bit further away from the Beis HaMikdash and didn't know exactly what time the Korban Omer was brought, Mutarin Mechatzos Hayom Ulehalon, they were allowed to eat the new Tevuah from midday and on. Lefish ain't Beis Din Misatlim Boy, because Beis Din, who were responsible for making sure the Korban Omer was brought, they were never lazy and they made sure to do it at the first possible moment. And therefore, by midday, it would definitely have been done. So if so, if you're worried about the Beis HaMikdash being built on the day before the 16th, on the 15th, then just Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai should have just instated that right through the Golus, they should only eat Chodosh after midday. Why would there ever be a concern of eating Chodosh after midday? Answers the Gemara, Loi, Tzricha, Di'ibonne Belaylo, maybe the completion of the Beis HaMikdash will be right at the end of the day of the 15th, or sometime in the night of the 16th, and they will be otherwise preoccupied. They will not have enough time to prepare the Korban Omer. And therefore the Korban Omer, maybe that first year, will only be brought after Chatzos. And therefore, Min HaTorah will be also to eat Chodosh until after Chatzos. And therefore, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated that in fear for this particular one interesting scenario, that the Beis HaMikdash is exactly going to be built in the very last minute and they will delay the bringing of the Omer by a few hours, therefore right through the Golus, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai stated, don't eat Chodosh the whole day of the 16th, in order that when the Beis HaMikdash gets rebuilt and people don't know exactly when the Korban Omer will be brought, they will continue the tradition of not eating the Chodosh the whole day of the 16th, And there won't be any takala, nothing will go wrong. Continues the Gemara. Omer of Nachum by Yitzchok. Omer Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, Beshitas Rabbi Yehuda Omer. Rabbi Nachum by Yitzchok said that Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai in our Mishnah is actually not a rabbinical instating because we were afraid of what would be if the Beis HaMikdash would be rebuilt. And as we said before, that they learned that Min HaTorah, when there's no Beis HaMikdash, you can eat Chodosh immediately in the morning. No. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai actually followed an opinion that we know that a Talmud of his, Rabbi Yehuda, already said, but it wasn't a Talmud of a Talmud, it was already said by Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai held that way. The Omar Min HaTorah hu da'asar. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai held that Min HaTorah you're not allowed to eat Chodosh in the time when there's no Beis HaMikdash for the whole day of the 16th. When there's the Beis HaMikdash and they would bring the Korban Omer, then one was allowed to eat Chodosh whenever the Korban Omer was brought. When there was no Beis HaMikdash, not like we said before, you can eat Chodosh immediately in the morning. No, you cannot eat Chodosh the whole day. Chassid it says in the Pasuk, Ad etzem hayom hazeh. It says, V'lechem v'koli v'charmel lo yisoichlu ad etzem hayom hazeh. Ad aviyachem es korban eloyichem chuk haseilem l'doroyseichem b'chol l'doroyseichem b'chol moishvoyseichem. What does it mean, ad etzem hayom hazeh? It doesn't mean from the onset of the day. It means ad itzumei shel yom. It means until the day proper. Ukasov v'ad v'ad b'chlel. And what this means, Rashi says, is that the entire day, ad etzem hayom hazeh, means until the completion of the whole day, you're not allowed to eat the Chodosh Tevuah unless there's a Beis HaMikdash and the Korban has been brought. And he holds that it's Min HaTorah and not Midrabbanan. Asks the Gemara, Umisovar Leikavosei? Could Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai and Rabbi Yehuda hold the same opinion that Min HaTorah, when there's no Beis HaMikdash, you're not allowed to eat Chodosh the whole day? V'miflik pligi olei. Rabbi Yehuda is going to argue with Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, the Tanya, because we learned in the Mishnah, Mishachorav Beis HaMikdash, after the Beis HaMikdash was destroyed, Hiskin, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai instated Sheyayim Anaf, the day that the Omer was supposed to be waived, the 16th of Nisan, Kuloi, the whole day, Osir is Osir. Omalu Rabbi Yehuda, and Rabbi Yehuda argued with Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai and challenged him and said, "V'aloi min HaTorah hu osur. Why are you saying Hiskin Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai? It was as if it's Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai instated this, making a new takona. No, it's also min HaTorah. Tchsiv ad etzem hayom hazeh ad itzumei shel yom. As we saw before, Rabbi Yehuda holds that min HaTorah you're not allowed to eat Chodosh the whole day in the event that there's no Korban Omer. Says the Gemara, it's not that there was really a machlekas. Rabbi Yehuda hu dekatoi. Rabbi Yehuda made a mistake. Rabbi Yehuda thought hu sovar midrabbanan komer. He thought that Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai said that it's also midrabbanan to eat Chodosh, and therefore he argued and says no, it's also min HaTorah. V'lohi, And it's not true. Midoraisa ka'omar. It could well be that Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai held, that minatayri, you're not allowed to eat chadosh if in the event that there's no korban oimer. Asks the Gemara of Ohiskin ka'omar, does it not use the term hiskin, which means instated, which seems to be it was a new gezeira, a new decree midrabanon? Says the Gemara, my hiskin, what does it mean he instated? Not that he made it up as his own chashash, his own gzeira. No. Dorash v'hiskin. He learned the posuk. He understood from the posuk that min hatayra, one's not allowed to eat chodosh until the end of the day in the event that there's no korban oimer. V'hiskin, and therefore he instated and says, even though till now, all the while, there was a beis hamikdash, you could all eat chodosh as soon as the korban oimer was brought, either any time in the morning when you know the korban oimer was brought, or midday, when you weren't sure exactly what time. That's only because there was a beis hamikdash. Now says Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai that there's no longer a beis hamikdash, then I've understood from the psukim that min hatayra you're not allowed to eat chodosh until the end of the day, and therefore he decreed and told everybody no more eating chodosh until the end of the day of the 16th. Continues the next Mishnah. Yom Tov Arishon Shel Chag, the first day of Sukkos. And the Gemara is going to discuss later on, we're talking about the time of the Beis HaMikdash. Shechol Yais B'Shabbos. It was Shabbos in the time of the Beis HaMikdash. We saw before that in the Beis HaMikdash day, Min HaTorah, there's a Chiyuv 7 days to take the Lulav. And in Gvulin, anywhere else outside the Beis HaMikdash, was 1 day, just that first day. And if that first day was on Shabbos, Kol Ha'om Meilichin Es Lulavim LeBeis HaKnesses. We'll learn later on Daf Mem Gimel what changed, but in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, they would shake lulav even on Shabbos. But to carry in Roshus HaRabim, in a public domain, to bring the lulav to the shul, that you're not allowed to do. So what did they do? Kol Ha'om Meilichin Es Lulavim LeBeis HaKnesses, all the people would bring their lulavim to the shul. Lemochros, the next morning, on Shabbos morning, the first day of Sukkos, Mashkimin Uboim, they would come early to shul, and Kol Echod Ve'echod Makir Es Shiloh, and everybody would recognize which is his set of Arba Minim, his lulav. V'noitle, and he would take it, and he would use it to be Mekayim, the mitzvah, to fulfill the mitzvah of lulav. Why did they have to make sure that everybody recognized his own set? B'pnei Sh'amur Chachomim, the Chachomim said, Ein Odim Yetzi, Dei Chivasi, B'yom Tavarishin, B'lulavi Shel Chaviri, because on the first day of Sukkos, then the Chachomim said, a person is not fulfilled the mitzvah of lulav with somebody else's lulav. It has to be his own, it has to be lochem. We've already learned about this. V'shayim Oysachag, however, all the other days of Yom Tov, Odim Yetzi, Dei Chivasi, B'lulavi Shel Chaviri, a person is allowed to fulfill his mitzvah of lulav with his friends Arba Minim, with his friends lulav. And there's a discussion here in the Mefarshim whether the words Beshar Yomoy Sachag, the other days of Yom Tov, that a person is allowed to use lulav shel chaveri, his friends lulav, and there's no issue of lochem, is that even in the Beis HaMikdash, where there was a chiyuv min hatayra to take lulav all 7 days, did lochem only apply the first day, or is this clause of the Mishnah actually talking about after the Churban Beis HaMikdash, and they took the lulav all 7 days outside the Beis HaMikdash, because we already said before that during the time of the Beis HaMikdash, they only took the lulav 1 day outside the Beis HaMikdash. So this part of the Mishnah will have to be speaking about after the Churban Beis HaMikdash, where they would take it all 7 days, since only the first day is Min HaTorah, only the first day is Lochem, the other days there's no issue of Lochem, and this is a discussion in the Mefarshim here. Continues the Mishnah. Rabbi Yosi Omer, Yom Tov Arishon Shel Chag Shechol Yais B'Shabbos. What happens when Sukkos turned out the first day of Sukkos was on Shabbos, and V'shochach V'hoitzi Es Alulav L'Roshus HaRabim, and for whatever reason, he forgot that it was Shabbos, and since we said already previously that on the first day of Sukkos they would take the lulav even if it was Shabbos, because the issue of taking lulav is primarily an issue of mukta, and mukta is only also midrabanon, and therefore the chiyuv and the mitzvah of sukkah of lulav overrides the issa of mukta. However, to carry in Roshus HaRabim, that's asa. What happens if somebody by mistake carried in the Roshus HaRabim? Then since carrying is one of the melachas, and doing it b'mezid is chiyuv koros, and b'shoigig should be chayev chatos, is he chayev chatos? Says the Mishnah, no. Potter is potter from a chatos, mipnei shoitziu b'roshus, because he was confused and he was very much torud bidvar mitzvah. He had every right and permission to be very involved in the mitzvah of lulav, and therefore he would be sort of forgiven for having made this mistake. And he's, since he's called a toyer bidvar mitzvah, and it's called hoitziyoi b'rishus, his being active with the lulav was done with permission, and therefore he does not have to bring a chatos, even though he was clearly not allowed to take the lulav into the rishus harabim. Says the Gemara, minohan emili, what would be the source that a person is not yetzer using the lulav of his friend, on the first day at least? Detan rabbonon, we learnt in a Brisa, and we're going to learn more about this on Daf Mem Gimel. It says in the Pasuk, Ulekachtem Lochem Bayoim Arishon, you have to take on the first day of Sukkot, Pri Eitz Hadar, etc. The Ulekachtem, the taking has to be Lochem, it has to be yours, Mishalochem, it has to belong to you. Lohoitzi es Hashol, to exclude a borrowed lulav, Vesagozel, or a stolen one. Mikan omru chachomim, and this is the source of what the chachomim said, that ein odom yetzer yidei chivase, a person cannot fulfill his requirement of the mitzvah of lulav b'yom tov rishon shel chag, on the first day of yom tov of sukkos, b'lulavi shel chaveri, with the lulav that's not his. Elohim kein nosnu lo b'matona, unless it was given to him as a gift. If somebody gives, if Reuven gives Shimon a lulav as a gift on yom tov, then Shimon can use it, it's his. But if it's not a gift, if it belongs to Reuven and Shimon is using it, that's an issue. When Ma'aseh ben Gamliel, there was an incident with Gamliel, Rabbi Yeshua, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, Rabbi Akiva. These four chachomim, shoyboim b'sfina, they were traveling in a ship. Not the first time that we've mentioned some of these chachomim on a ship in this mesechta. V'lo hayo lulav elo l'Rabbi Gamliel bilvad. Rabbi Gamliel was the only one who had the lulav. Shelokchi b'elev zuz, he had paid for his arba minim 1,000 zuz. Not Rabbi Gamliel. Rabbi Gamliel took the lulav on the morning of Sukkos. V'yatzabay, and he was yetzi, fulfilled his mitzvah. V'nosta Rabbi Yeshua b'matona, he gave it to Rabbi Yeshua as a gift. Now it was exclusively Rabbi Yeshua's. Not Rabbi Yeshua v'yatzabay, Rabbi Yeshua took it and fulfilled his mitzvah. V'nosta Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, and then he gave it to Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah b'matona as a gift. Not Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah v'yatzabay, then he took it and did the mitzvah of lulav. V'nosta b'matana l'Rabbi Akiva, and then he gave it as a gift to Rabbi Akiva. Not l'Rabbi Akiva v'yatzavoy, v'achziroi l'Rabbi Gamliel, and then they gave the arba minim, the lulav, back to Rabbi Gamliel, who was the original owner. That's what it says in the Braisa. And now the Gemara is going to discuss a number of points. L'omoli l'meimar echziroi. Why was it important for the Braisa to tell us that after they had all done the mitzvah of lulav, they gave the estrog, the lulav, back to Rabbi Gamliel? Answers the Gemara, Milsa agav urche kumash malon, the Braisa wants to teach us an added halacha, by the way, that matona al manos lehachzer shmo matona, that this was talking about the, when Rabbi Gamliel gave the lulav as a gift to Rabbi Yeshua, he gave it to him on condition that at the end of the day, it comes back to Rabbi Gamliel. It was a gift al manos lehachzer with a condition that it gets returned. So I might have thought that since it's a condition to returning it, it's not considered that it belongs, lochem, it belongs to the people who received it temporarily. The chiddush is no. Even though that was the condition, all the providing that indeed it gets back to Rabbi Gamliel, all the while it's given as a gift, even just temporarily, to anybody, it's considered lochem, and that person can be yetzer the mitzvah of lulav with it. Ki hado amar Rava, heilucho esrog zeh al menos shetachziru li. When Rava says, take this estrog on condition that you give it back to me, not levi yotzaboy, you can take the estrog and be yotzer with it. Hechziroi, if you gave it back indeed afterwards, yotzer, he was yotzer. Lo yechziroi, if it transpires later that you did not give back the lulav back to its original owners, lo yotzer, then it will become clear that it was never given to you as a gift. It was borrowed, stroke, stolen, and therefore, and you were not yotzer the mitzvah. Continues the Gemara, Lomoli lemeimar shelokhi be'elev zuz. Why was it important to tell us how much Rabbi Gamliel paid for his estrog, or for his lulav, that he paid for his arba minim, 1,000 zuz? Why is that an important piece of information? Answers the Gemara, Loidiach kama mitzvahs chavivis alein, to impress on us how dear the mitzvahs were to them, and to what extent and price they were happy to pay for the arba minim. Omar lemar bara meimar l'Ravashi. Mar Bar Amemer said that Abba, my father, he loved his lulav so much, he would daven Shmoneh Esrei whilst holding the lulav. Asks the Gemara Meisvei, did we not learn that lo yoichaz odom in brachas, a person should not hold a tefillin biyodoi, tefillin in his hands, or a sefer Torah b'cheikoi, or a sefer Torah on his lap, or in his arms, v'yispalil whilst he's davening, v'lo yashdin ben mayim, nor should he urinate when holding them, v'lo yishan bohem, nor should he sleep when holding the tefillin, lo yishenes keva, v'lo yishenes arai, not a fixed and type of sleeping, and not even a temporary dozing off with whilst holding tefillin in his hands. V'ma Shmuel said that sakin, a knife, uka'ora, and a plate, v'kikor, a loaf, umois, and money, all these harelu kiyotze ben, they are similar to tefillin, sefer Torah, etc., that he shouldn't be holding them whilst davening. Why? Because we're afraid that his mind is going to be focused on the knife not falling down and hurting his leg, or the plate not falling down and smashing, or the loaf not falling down and getting ruined, or the money getting scattered, and then his mind will not be focused on tefillah. When you're davening, you have to have a full concentration. So the question is, how could Ameimer hold his lulav during Shmoneh Esrei when you're not supposed to be holding anything when davening? Answers the Gemara, Hosam, all those things we mentioned before, lav mitzvah ninu. There's no mitzvah to hold them. The Toridbu, and that's why he's otherwise occupied by them, and his focusing on them will distract him from davening. Hocha, however, here with the lulav, mitzvah ninu. It's a mitzvah for him to hold the lulav. V'loy Toridbu, and Rashi says, since it's a mitzvah, mitoich shechaviva mitzvah lov, since the mitzvah is so dear to him, ein masa'o v'shimura kovid elov, the weight and protecting it is not a burden on him, v'loy Torid, it doesn't distract him. Continues the Gemara. Tanya Rabbi Lezer Rabbi Tzadok Omer, kach hayom min hagon shel anshei Yerushalayim. The people of Yerushalayim had the following custom. Adam yetzei mibeisoi, he would leave his house. V'lulavei biyadoi, he would hold the lulav with him. Hoylech lebeis haknesses, he would go to shul. Lulavei biyadoi, he would still be holding the lulav. Kair kriya shema o mispalil, he would say the shema and Shmoneh Esrei. V'lulavei biyadoi, it was so dear to them, they wouldn't put down their arba minim. Kair batayra, when he's reading in the Torah and he has to have two hands available to hold and roll the Sefer Torah. V'noises kapov, or when he does the Birchas Kehanim and he needs his two hands available. Manicha el gabakarka, for a few moments, he's allowed to put the lulav down on the ground. Hoylech levakar chaylim, if he then goes to visit the sick, ulenachim aveilim, and to console those who are in mourning, lulav biyadi, the lulav would be with him. Nichnas lebeis hamedrash, and he'd go into the Beis HaMedrash in order to learn Torah. And it was important that he has full focus on the learning, and he wouldn't chas v'shalom want his concentration on his learning to cause him to accidentally drop the lulav. And therefore, Meshagir lulavoi biyad benoi, he would deposit the lulav with his son, or biyad avdoi, or with his slave, or biyad shluchoi, or with some other agent, and they should watch it for him. Maiko mashmalon. What is this Braisa coming to teach us? Reason for mitzvahs, how meticulous they were with the mitzvahs, how dear the mitzvahs were to them, that they would hold the lulavim all day. Continues the Gemara, B'yosi Oimer, Yom Tov, Horishin Shel Chag, Shechol Yos B'Shabbos, V'Shochach V'Yitzias Halulav L'Roshus Harabim, Potom Mishum Shoyitziyei B'Roshus. This we saw in the Mishnah. Rabbi Yosi said that if somebody by mistake carried the lulav in Rosh Hashanah, which is seriously also, since he had permission to be occupied and concerned about the mitzvah of lulav, then he does not need to bring a chatos, even though he was not allowed to take it in the Rosh Hashanah. Says the Gemara, Omar Abaye, lo yishonu, it's only true that his potter is exempt from bringing the chatos for having by mistake carried in the Rosh Hashanah, elo shelo yotzoboy, only provided he has not yet fulfilled his mitzvah of lulav. And since he's not yet fulfilled his mitzvah, he's concerned and preoccupied by it. And therefore, if he went out in haste into the Rosh Hashanah, then he does not need to bring a chatos. Aval yotzoboy, if he's already fulfilled the mitzvah of lulav, he therefore no longer has an excuse to be overly concerned about the lulav. Therefore, he had no permission to forget, so to speak, to go into the Rosh Hashanah. And therefore, it's a regular shegig and is chayev chatos. asks the Gemara, Hamida Agbe Nofakbe. We're talking about that he carried the lulav in Rishus HaRabim. You can't carry it unless you've lifted it and are holding it. The moment you've lifted up your lulav, you've already been Yaitza. So you never have an opportunity where you're in the Rishus HaRabim with your lulav and you haven't yet been Yaitza. So what does Abaye mean? Answers the Gemara, Amar Abaye, Kishahofchoy. We're talking about where he was holding the lulav, or the esrog, he was holding it upside down, and we know that there's halacha that if you hold it, that you can only be mekayim the mitzvah of the lulav or the arba minim if you're holding them the right way up, and therefore it could well be that he was holding them upside down, so he had not yet fulfilled the mitzvah, and nonetheless he's carrying in the Rishus HaRabim, and that's what Abaye said, that only in that case, when you've not yet done the mitzvah, you're potter from chatos. But had you already done the mitzvah, then you'll be chai of the chatos. And we're going to learn about this a little bit more later on Daf Mem Hei, that you're only yotza derech gedilus on if you hold the arba minim in the right position, in the way that they grew. Rava Omar. Rava says, afilu teima shelo hafchi. Rava says that even if he didn't turn one of the arba minim upside down, nonetheless, we can understand Abaye. If he took it out when holding the lulav, the esrog, in a utensil, then in that case, you're certainly not being yotze the mitzvah. Nonetheless, you're carrying. And therefore, what Abaye said makes sense, that you could be carrying, and still there could be a case where you have been yotze, and it could be a case where you've not yet been yotze. Asks the Gemara of Rava Uda Omar, was it not Rava himself who said on the Flamed Zayin that if you take the Arba Minim via something else, which means there's separation between your hand and the Lulav or the Esrog, it's considered you've taken them. So how can Rava say that if you're holding the Lulav or the Esrog in a utensil, then you haven't been Yaitza? Why is it different to wearing a glove or to putting a scarf around your hand and holding the lulav, where there Rava says you're Yaitza? So over here also you should be Yaitza, says the Gemara. No. Hanemili derech kovid. That's only when you put a scarf around your hand, that's more of a respectable way of taking the lulav. And therefore Rava says it's lekicha lidei davachir, shmo lekicha, as we saw in Daf Lamed Zayin Omad Aleph. However, in the case where it's a little bit of a degrading way, aval derech bizoyin, but to take the lulav of the esrog when the lulav of the esrog is inside a utensil, that's a very degrading way of taking the lulav that's not or the esrog that's not considered taking loy, and therefore you've not been yotze the mitzvah. And therefore Abaye says it's only in a case like that where you have permission to be concerned, so to speak, and if you went into the Rishus HaRabim with it, that you're potter from the chatos. Continues the Gemara. And this is a similar theme now to what we see in what Rabbi Yossi said in the Mishnah, that we're going to have a case where a person is allowed to be concerned and occupied with trying to do a mitzvah, and by mistake, he did a serious Aveira. And the question is, how far we go with forgiving him or with allowing him not to have to bring a relevant korban because of his mistake? What was it talking about there? Omer Rav Huna. Rav Huna says that Oy Mahoyo Rabbi Yossi. Rabbi Yossi used to say as follows. We know that in the Beis HaMikdosh, bird could be brought as a korban, either as an oila or as a chatos. The oila sa'if was not allowed to be eaten. If you eat an oila sa'if, it's a me'ila. And there's a korban, you have to bring a korban me'ila. A chatos sa'if, there's a mitzvah to eat it. What happens if an oila sa'if was shenimtzeis bein agapayim? Agapayim are the other birds that melika had been done. Melika is a procedure which is in the place of shechita, just very different to shechita. When we learn kolchim, we learn about that more. But the oila sa'if, such a bird, which is an oila, is not allowed to be eaten. That was found bein agapayim between all the oilas chatos. Between all the chatos oif, sorry. Ukasova and this person thought chatos oif, he thought this bird is a chatos. If it's a chatos, the mitzvah to eat it. And he ate it, and then he realized, oi, it wasn't a chatos, it was an oila. You're not allowed to eat it. I've transgressed me'ila. I have to bring a korban me'ila. Va'ochran, he ate it. Nonetheless, potter is potter from bringing korban me'ila. The question is, Michael Mashmalon, what's Rav Huna trying to impress on us by telling us what Rabbi Yossi would hold? It's exactly what it says in our Mishnah, that if somebody is trying to do a mitzvah, needs to do a mitzvah, like take the lulav, and he transgresses the issa of going into Rosh Hashanah on Shabbos, he's parted from the chatos. So he's saying the same here, that since this person was allowed to be focused and otherwise preoccupied in doing the mitzvah of eating the chatos, he ate the oilot, he doesn't need to bring the korban. Says the Gemara, there's a fundamental difference between the Mishnah here with lulav and the case over there. The Torah bidvar mitzvah, Maika Mashmalon, the Torah bidvar mitzvah potter. What are you going to tell us that the Chiddush of Huna is telling us is that Torah bidvar mitzvah, if you made a mistake whilst doing a mitzvah, whilst having permission to be concerned about a mitzvah that is potter, hainu hach, it's exactly what it says in our Mishnah. Mao the Tamer says the Gemara, I may have thought, Hosam, in the case of the lulav, who the Torah bidvar mitzvah potur, hainu d'ovad mitzvah. It could be in the case of the lulav, he went out into Rosh Hashanah. But at the end of the day, he was mekayim the mitzvah of lulav. So maybe in that case, he doesn't need to bring a chatos. Aval hocha, but in the case of the birds that got mixed up, the Torah bidvar mitzvah, it's true that he was otherwise preoccupied with the mitzvah of eating the chatos, but v'lo ovad mitzvah, he ate the oila, there's no mitzvah to eat the oila, it's navera to eat the oila. So maybe in that case, maybe in that case, we don't say that he's potter from Me'ilah, since he didn't do a mitzvah, and therefore he would have to bring a korban Me'ilah. Komash Malon Rav Huna says, no. Rabbi Yossi says that if you have permission to be otherwise preoccupied, even if afterwards it turns out that you didn't do the mitzvah at all, nonetheless you're potter from bringing the korban. Asks the Gemara Meisui, Rabbi Yossi Oimir. Again, Rabbi Yossi said, Hashreichet es atomid she'enei mevukor, we know there's halacha, and it's essential, it's ma'akev, that in order to bring a korban, the lamb, the korban tomid as the korban in the Beis HaMikdash, it has to have been examined 4 days before. And if not, you're not allowed to bring it. It's ma'akev, you can't bring it as a korban tomid. This person took such an animal that's not been examined, and he shechted it for the korban tomid, but Shabbos on Shabbos. You're not allowed to shecht on Shabbos, it's one of the lamates melachas, it's shechet. In the Beis HaMikdash, if you do it right, you're allowed to, as we learned in Maseches Pesachim, that the korbonis, which have a fixed time in the Beis HaMikdash, override Shabbos. But here he wasn't Yotzei Tomid because it hadn't been examined. Even if it transpires that it was a kosher animal and there were no blemishes in it, nonetheless, if it hadn't been examined appropriately, it's not a kosher shechita for the Tomid. So then it turns out that you're Mechal Shabbos. And Rav Yossi says, Chayev Chatos. Number one is chayev to bring a chatos. He shechted an animal which was not a kosher shechita for the tomid. And also, a tzorach tomid achir, you have to bring another korban tomid. That korban tomid was not yotza. The question is, why is he chayev to bring a korban chatos? He's Torah bidvar mitzvah. He's allowed to be concerned and preoccupied with bringing the korban tomid. By mistake, he took an animal that hadn't been examined appropriately. Why should he be chayev chatos? That's the question. Omar Lee, so he answered him and said, Bar mino dai. Don't bring me proof from the Tomit. No, because normally Toya bidvar mitzvah is potter. Toh it ma'alo, Omer of Shmuel bar Chitoi, Omer of Amnuna Saba, Omer of Yitzchok bar Ashion, Omer of Huna, Omer Rav. It was said in the name of Rav that in that case is talking about Kugoin Sheviu Milishko She'enom Vukorim. There was a chamber of animals that had been examined. There was a chamber of animals that had not been examined. So he says, this animal came from the chamber of animals that had not been examined. You shouldn't be concerned about these animals at all. If it's an animal from the chamber that's been examined, and now you're preoccupied with taking that animal that has to get to the Mizbeach in the right way, okay, so you made a mistake. You don't need to bring the korban. Over here, why are you busying yourself with a non-examined animal, with an animal that came from the chamber of the animals haven't been examined? And are you going to say that, okay, so it wasn't this animal that was concerning me and confusing me, it was the fact that it was the time. Now I need to bring a korban tomid. It's the morning. And maybe he got confused and by mistake took the wrong animal. Rashi says that's also no excuse, because it was very close to being a careless mistake to take an animal, even in a time like that, to take an animal from the wrong chamber. It's almost unforgivable. And therefore, if you made that mistake, you have to bring a korban chatos. And therefore, that's different, because it was a very, very bad mistake. However, in the cases before where he ate the oilas oif instead of the chatos oif, or in the case that he went into the Rosh Hashanah with his lulav, there he was a toya bidvar mitzvah, and Rabbi Yossi says that toya bidvar mitzvah is potter to bring a korban. And Yemirtz Hashem, in the next shir, we're going to continue with the next Mishnah.